5.
Well, best. I think that's pretty cool. Plus, Blake Lau, I don't know if you know him, sophomore, he placed 12th in the state as an individual, so that's a pretty good deal. All right, so here we go. This is quiz A. I would suggest that if you do not have quiz A, you write this problem down on a piece of paper and work through it with me. This is our practice. This is our practice. We will be having another quiz very soon. If not today, tomorrow for sure. So we need to make sure we know what's going on here. So here we go. This is a circle. In the direction, say, find the center and the radius. To do that, we group our X's together and our Y's together. Does this look familiar to you? Right? Now we're going to complete the square. So half of 2 is 1. Squared is 1. Add it on both sides. Half of 4 is 2. Squared is 4. Added to both sides. The reason that you did that was so that you could write this like this. This one would be x plus, it always matches that sign, 1. This one would be y minus 2. And we just total all those up and we get 15. Right? So, you now should be able to look at that equation and tell me the center and the radius. The center is, watch it, it's always the opposite. So the center would be negative 1, positive 2. And the radius is always the square root of that number. That number is r squared, x squared, y squared, r squared. So the radius is the square root of 15. Now that was the question on quiz A. The circle question on quiz B was this. So now we're going to do this one. Would you agree it looks exactly the same as this one? So we're going to do exactly the same thing. So we'll group our X's together and leave a blank. We'll group our Y's together and leave a blank. And then we're going to add those two blanks to the other side. So again, if you do not have quiz B, you might want to write this problem down and work through it with us for practice so that you will be ready for the quiz either later today or certainly tomorrow. All right, so here we go. Half of 6 is 3 squared is 9 both sides. Don't forget to add it to both sides. Half of 8 is 4 squared is 16. Add it to both sides. So we have x minus 3 squared, right? Plus y plus 4 squared equal to a total of 29. So where is my center and radius this time? My center is 3, negative 4, and my radius is square root of 29. Anybody have a question about the circle? Okay, now let's go back to quiz A. The other problem was a parabola. So here's our parabola for quiz A. If you don't have quiz A, write this problem down and work through it with us. We need the vertex, the focus, the directrix, and the focal width. With a circle, it's center and radius. With this guy, it's all that. Now, do you remember when we talked about these before? And prepared for this quiz, actually, I said these two should be automatic for you. You should be able to look at that equation and tell me the vertex. What is the vertex of that equation?
2,
comma, negative 3. So your vertex is at 2, negative 3. You should also be able to look at the equation and give me the focal width. What's the focal width? 8. That number right there is always the focal width. So nobody should miss a point on these two questions, because you can look at the equation. And I'm going to give you the equation in that form, so you don't even have to mess with the equation. It's right there. These two are a little bit trickier. In order to know these two, you need to know which way your parabola opens. What does it look like? Is it up, left, right, down? What is it? This one is up. How do I know it's up? X squared, 8, positive. X squared is up. Y squared is sideways. Remember, y side, y squared is sideways. X squared is up and down. Because that number is positive, it opens up. That means that your focus is straight above it and your directrix is straight below it. Now, in order to know where your focus is, you need to know this distance, right? And we call that P. That distance from the vertex stepping up to the focus is called P. Anybody remember how to find P? 4P is always this number. That number serves double duty. It is the focal width, and it's 4P. If 4P is 8, then P is 2. So you're going to start right here and count up 2. If you count up 2 steps, where are you for your focus? What? Over 2, down 1? 2, negative 1? Now, if you went up 2 for your focus, you're going to go down 2 for your directrix. And where will you be? Now, be careful. That point would be 2, negative 5, right? If you come down 2. But the directrix is a line. It's an equation. What is that equation? Y equals negative 5. Beautiful. Y equals negative 5. Remember, whatever axis it crosses is the letter that you use. It crosses the y-axis at negative 5. Y equals negative 5. Now, let's look at the B quiz, the same problem on the B quiz, or the parabola problem. And let's go through it. And again, we need vertex, focus, directrix, and focal width. All right, here we go. These two, you better be able to just fill in.
-1, 3.
Ooh, be careful. That's tricky. Not on purpose. It just happens this way sometimes. It's 3, -1. When we write an ordered pair, we always have to put the X number first. So that, it will be like that sometimes. You just have to be paying attention. All right, what about the focal width? 4. Okay, that's easy. Now, to answer these, I need to know which way I open. So here's my vertex at 3, -1. Pay attention to two things. Which letter is squared? And is that number positive or negative? Okay, so which way is it going to open?
Right.
It's y squared, which is sideways, and it's positive, which is right. So this guy opens to the right. Now that means that somewhere in here, straight to the right, is going to be your focus. Right? We got to figure out how many steps we have to take. How far far is it from here to here? We call it P. Look at your equation. What do we know? It's 1. That's right, Alex. 4P is 4, which means P is 1. So we are going to start right here and go one step forward. So where will I be if I go one step forward? Take one step forward. You'll be at 4, negative 1. I've said this a zillion times. You can use graph paper. It's not always one step forward. This one was one step up. It depends which way the parabola opens. That's why we graph it. So we know whether we're going up or down or sideways. We need to know. If you took one step forward for your focus, you're going to take one step backward for your directrix. And if you back up one step, this would be 2, negative 1, right? But it's not a point. It's a line that crosses the x-axis at 2. So your directrix is x equals 2. Okay? Bill?
If it were I minus 1 squared, would the parabola be open? Or going like that?
No. The vertex has nothing to do with it. The only way it would open left is if that was a negative number. The vertex is the vertex. It doesn't have anything to do with the direction of opening.
But because like the y was first, is that why?
Because it's y squared is why it opens sideways.
Right, okay.
Yeah, yeah. Whatever letter is squared, y squared is sideways, x squared is up and down. All right, now, the quiz, the next quiz that we take, will have a third problem on it. The third problem will look like this. I would suggest you get out a piece of paper and maybe write this down. This is not a circle. Look at your quiz and remember what circles look like. This is not a circle. This is certainly not a parabola. What is this? It's the last thing we talked about. What is it? It's a what? Okay, get your note sheets out. It's an ellipse. This is an ellipse. I will always give you the ellipse in standard form, so the equation's going to look like that. You don't have to do anything to the equation. It is ready for you. However, you do need to find the center, the vertices, the foci, the major axis, and the minor axis. Now, some of those are really easy, and one of them is a little bit more complicated. Let's take care of the really easy stuff. Where is the center of that ellipse?
1, -3.
Perfect. The center is at 1, -3.
I didn't know.
Now, if you have been paying any attention at all, that's not confusing to you. Because it is exactly what we do with a circle. It's exactly what we do with a parabola. It's the opposite of those. Make sure you got them in the right order. X, comma, Y. Now, see that 4 right there? Who remembers what that 4 does? I take the square root of it and I get 2. And then what do with that 2? Look at your notes and see if you can figure it out from the examples we did in class. Luke, get your notes out. I know you have them. They're in there somewhere. Pause. all wear your notes. Get them out, come on. Avery, can you figure out from your notes what we do with those? Yeah.
It just tells you how far you
went. Or not this one. This one tells me how far I went sideways, but yeah. The denominators, you're getting ready to graph this thing. Your denominators tell you how far to count out in all the directions. So the fact that that's a 4 under x means I'm going to count sideways 2 units. So where will I be if I count sideways 2 units? This would be 3 -3, and this would be -1 -3. Very good. Feel free to use graph paper. Now, if a 4 underneath the x told me to go back and forth 2, what do you think a 16 under the y means? Up and down 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, what are the coordinates of these points?
1, -7.
1, -7 down here, yep. And 1, 1. Those 4 points, go ahead and connect them. Those 4 points make the vertices. Their center was at 1, -3. So you're going to have 4 points for your vertices. And the order doesn't matter. Just get all 4 of those written down. There they are. So again, what did we use those denominators for? They tell us how far up and down, how far left and right to count to place our vertices. Now, as soon as you do that, you can answer these 2 questions. How long is the major axis? In other words, you went up and down how many?
8.
Well, you went up and down 4, so the total thing is 8?
Yeah.
I haven't done my foci yet. Be careful there. All 4 of those are vertices. And then I went sideways 2, so my minor axis is 4. Now, the only thing I haven't figured out yet is where my foci are. Foci, plural for focus. Where are my foci? Well, they are always located on the long axis, on the major axis. Remember talking about this? I said, even if you can't remember how to do it, or if it's hard or whatever, you can get half credit. How can I get half credit? Look at your picture. What do you know about these 2 points?
It's on the 1.
And again, if you're using graph paper, that's going to pop right out at you. X has to be 1. Now, to get the other half credit, you have to know how far up and down to go. Anybody remember how to do that, or can you tell from your notes what arithmetic we did? Exactly. Again, the keys, the denominators. The distance from the center to the focus is the square root of 16 minus 4, which is 2 root 3. 12, square root 12. So I'm going to start right here at negative 3. And I'm going to go up 2 root 3. So this will be negative 3 plus 2 root 3. I'm starting at my center, which is down at negative 3. And I'm going to go up 2 root 3. And then I'm going to come down 2 root 3. So my focus points are 1, comma, negative 3 plus 2 root 3, and 1, comma, negative 3 minus 2 root 3. Now that's a little more complicated, but everything else is super simple. Let's do one more example of that. let's try them. Alright, so here we go. Where's our center?
-2, -3.
So that's where everything starts. And again, nobody should miss that. That should be super simple points. -2, -3. Right? Now, what about my vertices? Those are the points that I draw and connect. Well, that's easy. The 9 tells me to go left and right 3. How do I know left and right? It's under X. So I'm going to go left and right 3. So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. What are the coordinates of these points? I went straight sideways 3. 1, -3. And this way would be -5, -3. Good. Now, 3 sideways. How much up and down? 1. Square root of 1 is 1. So up 1 and down 1. What are these points? I went straight up 1, so that would be, no, -2, -2. And this one would be -2, -4. Remember, you're going up and down. So I'll connect those. A little skinny one this time. There it is. How long is my major axis?
Major, always the bigger one.
Always the bigger one. Major is always the bigger one. That's what major means. How long is my major axis? 6. Why is it 6? Because we went back and forth 3. How big is my minor axis? 2. Because I went up and down 1. Right? Now, comes the hard one. Oh, that's easy. Everybody should get those points. Here comes the hard one. The foci are somewhere on the long axis. They're always on the long axis. So here, they were up and down. Luke, you paying attention to this? Here they were up and down. Here they are sideways. Everybody understand why? They're always in the long direction. So this is hard. This is confusing. It's got radicals. It's weird. But half of it you ought to be able to know. All these points. What do we know about all these points? Look at them. What do you know about them? Their y is -3. So you have half credit. Okay, now we have to say, if you want full credit now, we got to figure out how far that is. How do we find the distance from the center to the focus? How do we do that? 9 minus 1. Always the big one minus the little one, so that it stays positive. So that's the square root of 8, which is 2 root 2. Now, this is not 2 root 2. You start at the center, which is -2. And you go forward 2 root 2. So -2 plus 2 root 2. And -2 minus 2 root 2. Those are your focus points. Start at your center and add and subtract your distance. So my center was at -2, I added 2 root 2, I subtracted 2 root 2.
So you just used the X for the center and just added up the center.
Because you're going sideways, that's X, right? You're moving forward and backwards, so that is your X coordinate. Because you've already told me the Y coordinate's -3, you already told me that. right? Okay, now, get out your notes for me. Did you take complete notes? So what we're going to do now, tomorrow we will take a quiz. And the quiz will be like the one I just turned back, only it'll have three problems on it. So what are the three problems that are going to be on the quiz? It'll have a circle and a parabola, just like the other quiz, plus it will have one of these. Okay? And we just did two of each. So you need to practice that a little bit. You have more practice problems in your notes, certainly in your homework. Okay, now then, we have one more curve to talk about. And this is the most involved one. So we're on section 8.3, page 56 of your notes, and we have this equation. All right, does everybody pay attention? This is part of it's going to be so simple for you, because it starts out exactly the same as an ellipse. Now, some of you might be looking at this and saying, well, Mrs. Ford, I think that is an ellipse. Anybody see the difference? Anybody see why this is not an ellipse? It's a minus. And when it's a minus, you have a hyperbola. Now, everybody knows what a circle is. Everybody knows what a parabola is. Now we know what an ellipse is. An ellipse is an oval, right? Anybody know what a hyperbola is? What's a hyperbola look like? Well, there's hyperbole in English. You know, interestingly enough, there's an ellipsis in English too. So we have all these English things that overlap with our math. This is an example of a hyperbola. They can also open sideways. And if you remember, you had a BFF that actually was a hyperbola and opened diagonally. Remember that one? Anybody remember which BFF that is? It's a reciprocal function. Awesome, Paul. I'm going to give you a bonus point for that. No. That is awesome.
All right.
Now, none of our parabolas are going to, or hyperbolas, excuse me, none of our hyperbolas are going to be these diagonal things. Ours are always going to be either up or down, or either up and down or sideways, okay? Now, these are a little more complicated. Gotta take some notes. Up and down means it's y squared minus x squared. Sideways is x squared minus y squared. So it matters in the equation whether you have x squared minus y squared or y squared minus x squared. It makes a difference. And the difference is whether you have an up and down curve or whether you have a sideways curve. Okay, so there's the rule you need to remember for hyperbolas. Okay. Here's what we got. Which way is ours going to open? Side to side. All right, here we go. Where's the center of this hyperbola, do you think? Where's the center? 0, 0. why is the center at 0, 0? That is absolutely correct. Why is it at 0, 0? It doesn't have anything added or subtracted up here. Think about the ellipse we just did. I don't remember the exact numbers, but wasn't it like this? Where was this center? At 2, 3? Right? If there's nothing in there, then those are like zeros, aren't they? So we'll always know whether it's a circle, parabola, ellipse, or hyperbola. If there's nothing attached to the x and the y in the parentheses squared, it's going to be zero. So your center is at 0, 0. Now, what did this 9 tell us before?
Over in left and right 3.
Left and right 3. I want you to do the same thing. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. What did this 16 tell us before? Up and down 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, a minute ago when we had an ellipse, after we counted up and down 4 and sideways 3, we connected those points with an oval, right? We're not going to do that. This is not an ellipse. We're going to connect those points with a box. So I want you to draw a rectangle through those points. Now, there's nothing tricky about getting those points. We got them the same way we get them every time, right? Counted up and down 4, sideways 3.
Is it origin or origin?
No, it doesn't have to be the origin. This one is because I don't have anything added or subtracted. So our down at the bottom, we'll get to an example that's not at the origin. Now, what do I draw this box for? Well, once you get the box drawn, I want you to put in its diagonals. I am using dashed lines because that's traditionally how we indicate asymptotes. The word asymptote does have a P in it, but it's silent, and there is no P at the end. Don't say asymptote. It's asymptote. There are two of them, and they are the diagonals of your box. Now, what do? Well, they frame your curve. You told me that this one was going to open sideways. So we're going to start right here at the edge of the box, and we're going to draw in our parabola, a hyperbola. It is molded by these asymptotes. So you have a big, fat hyperbola. If the Y had come first, if this had been turned around, then we would be drawing in this hyperbola. These two points right here at the edge of the box, these are the vertices. So this is your vertex, and it has a coordinate of what? What is the coordinate of this point right here? -3, 0. And this one is 3, 0. So the hyperbola has just two vertices. Now, axis is called the transverse axis. Transverse means it joins the vertices. So here are your vertices. Transverse vertices is the axis that joins them. So your transverse axis is how long?
Six.
Now the other dimension of your box, which would be this guy right here, the other dimension of your box is called the conjugate axis. And in our problem, the conjugate axis is how long? 8. Now, in an ellipse, those are not called transverse and conjugate. In an ellipse, those are called major and minor, right? In an ellipse, major is the long one, minor is the short one. In a hyperbola, transverse is the one that joins the vertices, the actual curve, and then the other one is the conjugate. The blue thing, remember, is your actual picture. So this green line doesn't have anything to do with the actual picture. It's called the conjugate axis. Now, you can probably guess that Luke, what? You tell me what. I know you're not talking about the foci of a hyperbola.
I'm listening to you.
Okay, you need to shut your mouth and listen to me, okay?
Okay.
The foci of the hyperbola. Anybody want to take a wild guess, just generally speaking, in the picture where they're located? They're on the transverse axis, back behind it, actually. They're inside the curve. Does this kind of look like a parabola to you? If you look at just this piece, there would be the focus, right? Same thing over here. So they're located where you would think they would be located. Tell me what I know about those two points already before I even do anything. What I know, the y is 0. So just like with the ellipse, you can get half credit by just looking at the picture. Okay? Is it 9:30 already?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Okay. All right. Well, we will finish this one tomorrow. So we are not quite done. So Avery, I'm going to ask you to remind me. I still am not quite done with that one. And I will see you tomorrow for a quiz with 3 problems on it. Marissa, did you bring a pass?